guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your baby girl Yejide Adebola, aka Queen Yay. In today's video, guys, as the title says, I'm going to be showing you guys the tips and tricks on how to film like a pro using your mobile phone. This is actually due to popular demand because I film using my mobile phone. And I've gotten a lot of questions on how my videos come out very clear. And this is the reason why I decided to give you guys my tips in successfully filming clear YouTube videos using my mobile phone. Without too much intro, let's get right into the steps. Now, the very first step is lightning. Lightning is very, very important when filming any video, like any YouTube video, any content at all, even if it's for Instagram or most importantly YouTube videos. Lightning is like the most important yet underrated step. You might have the best camera quality or the best phone, but without proper lightning, it's zero. It's just like you filming at night and you filming in the morning. I mean, there's a huge, regardless of the phone grade, when you film at night without any light, it's obviously going to be dark. When you film in the morning without lightning, it's obviously going to be bright. This is natural lightning. Do you understand? However, when I say this is the most important step, it doesn't mean that you have to spend all your money on ring light or LED light or anything like that. If you're a beginner and you have no sufficient funds to, you know, maybe you're a new YouTuber or you're new to YouTube or you have no sufficient funds for ring light or LED light, the best thing for you to use is natural light. I say making Instagram videos, makeup videos using natural light as well. And natural light is actually the very best source of lightning, like when it comes to, you know, making videos. But the only disadvantage is that it cannot be controlled. I mean, you can still control your ring light, you can control the lightning, you can control how it will be, and it will stay permanent like that from the beginning of your video to the very end. But natural light cannot be controlled, you know, due to weather and all of that. But however, if you cannot afford ring light, you can actually start up using natural light. And you can plan out, maybe whenever you see that the sun is really shining, you can just quickly dress up and, you know, shoot your video. For people who are interested in getting ring light or LED light, I don't know, I heard that LED lights are actually better than ring light due to the fact that it doesn't bring so much heat like ring lights, because ring light actually brings heat. And I also heard that it's sharper. And but regardless, I feel like if you're a beginner and you want to be budget friendly, like you just need something that is, maybe you don't have enough but you just want to get one of it, I feel like you should just stick to ring light. Let's get the ring light that has the stand where you can put your phone on, so that way you don't really have to get a tripod stand. And that is what I've been using since, like I don't have a tripod stand, I just use my ring light to light and tripod in one. But when you get LED lights, it doesn't come with the stand, so when you get LED lights, you also have to get a tripod stand. Do you get? So if you're a new YouTuber or you just want to be budget friendly, you can actually just get a ring light that obviously comes with the stand as well, and that's just like two in one. You get? Another very important step when it comes to lighting is that you shouldn't back the light. I mean, don't back the source of light, face it. Like right now, my ring light is directly in front of me, it's not at my back, because I see a lot of YouTubers actually make that mistake, especially small YouTubers. They stay backing their windows. I'll show you an example of what I mean. This is me backing my light, and obviously you can see that there is a drop in quality. I mean, when you do like that, the light is not focused on you, so it's very hard for us to see your face well. Do not back the source of light, rather face it. The third step when it comes to lightning is that if the light is too bright, you can actually reduce it on your camera. I'm going to show you guys how to do that. Reduce the lightning a little and then lock the exposure. If you lock the exposure, then the light is not going to fluctuate. You know the way natural light fluctuates, like when there's sun and then the sun goes, it's not going to be like that, because sometimes it happens, like when you move this way, when you move this way, you want to make sure that no matter how much you move when you're making a YouTube video, the exposure is still the same, the lightning is still the same. Another very important step is to clean or wipe your lens before you shoot the video. This is something I even do unconsciously already, like when I'm with anybody's phone, if they tell me to take pictures of them, or if I want someone to take pictures of me, if I'm about to shoot a video, if I'm about to make Snapchat videos, any kind of videos at all, I'm so used to always cleaning the lens. And I feel like that's another very important step that everybody should adhere to, because sometimes your camera lens is not always clear and clean. You know, we put our phones in our pockets, put them on the table, put them in different places that can make the lens blurry. So when you shoot a video sometimes without cleaning it, your video comes out blurry. I mean, after making the video, you might just realize that, oh my god, my video is blurry. Do you get? So another very important step for you to adhere to is to clean or wipe your lens before you start shooting the video. Not to move far away from your phone, especially when you do not have a microphone. For example, I don't have a microphone, but my phone and all my light is directly in front of me. If I had a microphone, it can be very far. But due to the fact that I don't have a microphone, the best advice and the most important thing for you to do is to make sure it's very close to you so that people will be able to really hear what you're saying and be more interested in your channel and actually watch that video to the very end. So if they're not hearing what you're saying, that's a very big discouragement for them and they might just want to go off. Always use your back camera to film. Don't use the front camera when you want to film, especially when you're filming YouTube videos. The back camera is usually sharper than the front camera. When you use the front camera, it's also good sometimes, but it's never as sharp as the back camera. Sometimes when you use the front camera, you might think it's okay until you upload to YouTube and then you see that your video is coming out blurry. It's not coming out as sharp as you actually thought it was. Another disadvantage of using your front camera is that you tend to always stare at yourself. Like, it's like you're just looking at yourself, and it's very normal when you're videoing yourself and you're looking at the screen, you're looking at yourself and not the lens. You're not looking at your audience. But when you're using the back camera, you obviously cannot see yourself, so you're talking to the audience. Like, I'm like right now I'm facing you guys, I'm looking at you, unlike when I'm using my front camera and I'm just looking at myself and admiring myself. Do you understand? Change the settings on your iPhone, like even on your Android. Go to settings. In settings, you see the camera. When you go to camera, change the camera settings. Make sure that you're uploading in the highest available quality. It definitely will take more space than usual, which is the reason why before you shoot a YouTube video, you should clear a lot of unnecessary data so you don't have to have problems when you're filming videos, because I've actually gone through that same issue before. Then when I used to try to film videos, I might have spoken for up to 30 minutes. Like, I'm not even exaggerating, and I'll find out that nothing filmed because they are showing me insufficient space. And that's like after I've already concluded my video, then I now have to start deleting things and start the video all over again. So I'm sure you don't want to go through that same thing. And so before you film any video, you should clear your data, because now you're going to be videoing in the highest available quality. Another very important step is your editing app. After editing your video, it is advisable for you to save in 4K as well. So now you're filming in 4K and also exporting in 4K. When you film in 4K and export in 4K, when you upload to YouTube, like, your video comes out like the best. You don't even have any problem when it comes to uploading to YouTube, because then your video comes out sharp and almost the same as you, as the way you recorded it. You get, I would recommend iMovie or InShot for editing apps, because I've never really used iMovie because I don't really understand how to use it, but most creators actually use it and they believe that it's like the simplest app to use, and I think you can actually try it out because I've heard a lot of, you know, good reviews about iMovie. However, I use InShot and I feel like InShot is actually very, very good when it comes to editing. So when you're saving your video, you're saving to the highest available quality, which is also 4K. So you're filming in 4K and saving in 4K, which gives you a very perfect video quality, especially when you want to upload to YouTube. Now, another very important thing that I feel like a lot of YouTubers don't talk about when they make video content like this is to go to upload settings on your YouTube to upload in full quality rather than any other one it was before. Now you've made your YouTube video in 4K, you export in 4K, and you're also posting to YouTube in full quality. So like, that makes your YouTube video perfect and ready to watch, best for viewers. Do you understand? Have no problem with quality or anything that concerns quality if you go through all these steps, because once you go through all these steps, I feel like the only problem you should have is maybe your content or any other thing. But when it comes to quality, you're covered. When you're making a YouTube video, make sure you film horizontally, don't film vertically. Do you get? When you're filming, make sure it's horizontal like this. that's how you should film your YouTube videos. Because I noticed that a lot of people, especially new YouTubers, make that mistake of filming vertically. If you want to film vertically or in portrait mode, that should only be when you're trying to upload to shorts or reels in Instagram, shorts on YouTube. That's the only time you should be able to, you should film that way. But when you're filming to upload like a YouTube video, a normal YouTube video, then you want to film horizontally, because that's how YouTube has recommended that we, you know, shoot and upload our videos. Another step is to test your video before officially filming it. Make sure the audio is good, your sitting position is perfect, lighting is good, your looks, everything is in order before recording your video. You should do the test when making a short video first before officially sitting down to do the video. This is to make sure that everything is in order. You obviously don't want to film a whole YouTube video for up to 30 minutes and after the whole 30 minutes you find out that you didn't like the way you were looking, or you didn't like your position, you were not sitting in a comfortable place, your audio was bad, your microphone or something, you know. So it's better for you to actually test it first. Most people actually make sure a mirror is in front of their camera so that when they're using the back camera, you know, when you're using the back camera you cannot actually see how you look. So when there's a mirror in front of it, you can see through the mirror if you're in the perfect position and all of that. Except that you might not be able to know how your audio is, especially when you don't have a microphone. So it's better for you to still do a test run, check it out, then sit down back and, you know, shoot your video officially. I really hope this was helpful. If it was, please give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want more videos like this. Any kind of thing you guys want me to do on this channel, please let me know down in the description box below. I'll be willing and very happy to, you know, share more ideas with you all. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day. Bye.